I just wanted to take out the time and just thank my teammates, my family and friends, coaches, for helping me being able to achieve this goal. I feel like I couldn't have did it without them.
Was it coaching like Coach Dimble said?
Yeah, most importantly, I feel like that's what I need in order to do some great things, and I feel like they've been showing mad confidence in me this week.
Why did you embrace the role that he put you in?
You know, it's not, well, me, I'm not necessarily the type of guy that when I step onto the court, it's all about me. You know, I feel like it's most importantly about my team and whatever I can do to go out and compete and help us win, I'm always willing to do.
Armani, you and Derek are kind of an unlikely big guys in this league, size-wise. What makes you guys successful down there, and what do you have to do to be successful as an undersized guy down around the basket?
Yeah, I feel like as for me and Derek, I feel like we totally have something that's different from me and any other one of my teammates, because when we first came here, we was actually roommates, so we actually have this special type of bond that I feel like I know what type of player he is, he knows what type of player I am. So when we're in the game together, I feel like we're just able to click a whole lot better than maybe me and some of my other teammates.
Coach mentioned that he's really grown and wouldn't be playing if he wasn't willing to adapt. How have you kind of seen him find his way a little bit this season?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like Derek, we've seen his talent, you know, especially coming into the summer. You know, sometimes he might have struggled a little bit, but I mean, he had an injury back when it was freshman year. I think he had a torn labrum. So sometimes it's always about, you know, having that mentality where, you know, just because you have a setback that you can't bounce back. And I feel like he's been doing a great job this year just coming out and getting his level of confidence back.
Coach was talking about how the conditioning y'all did during the offseason has made you maybe a tougher team than some of the teams y'all play. Just what were those conditioning drills like during the offseason? What was y'all's reaction to them at the time?
Conditioning was very tough. You know, I never had a conditioning session where it was just constant running, you know, especially without breaks. So, I mean, for a lot of our guys, you know, especially having such a young team, you know, it was times where, like you said, some guys would quit, you know, have to do makeup runs. But I feel like through it all, we was able to gain a level of confidence where if we was able to get through that, then I feel like it was nothing that we can't get through.
What kind of difference do you think it's made during the season?
As you can see, you know, just related back to, you know, we lost the Alabama game, you know, we could have gave up right then and said, all right, man, I don't think we got a chance. But instead, we came out the next game and was able to bounce back.
Other than that stamina, what do you think has enabled Tennessee to win late on the road? What factors?
I know Coach Tanner always stresses the point that we might be known as a pressing team, but, like, sometimes in our press, you know, it's not necessarily to always steal the ball. Sometimes it's just to wear teams down, and hopefully, like you saw in Missouri, you know, sometimes they'll just end up giving the ball to us. It don't necessarily cause them to turn the ball over. But I feel like by us going through all that conditioning and stuff in the summer, we was able to wear down on teams a lot this year.
Martin, you guys are 3-1 in the SEC. I don't know what you guys expected. It seemed like maybe a little bit of an unexpected start. How do you guys kind of handle success and kind of keep this momentum going?
I say the most important thing for us right now as a team is just being able to stay humble. I mean, we can't really get ahead of ourselves. It's still a long season to go. And, you know, we as a team, I feel like we got a long way to go as well, because, you know, we really haven't did nothing yet. I mean, yes, we're 3-1, but like I said, any day we can be 3-3, you know, back at the bottom again. So as long as we can stay poised in our games and stuff and keep on coming into practice with the right mindset that we know we can't take any days light, then I feel like we can be very successful this year.
What were y'all's expectations going into the season? Have y'all surprised yourselves with what you've done so far?
No, I mean, I feel like we put the work in this summer. I feel like anybody else that had, like, different write-ups on us and stuff this summer, they're not doing the same work that we're doing. They're not in the gym day in, day out, you know, putting in major work. So I feel like it's not really a big shock for us. I feel like we know what we're capable of doing, so we're just now actually going out and doing it.
Armani, you had a difficult game at Mississippi State, got an early foul trouble. Seemed like you were a little out of control. Since then, you played a really good game. What happened in that game, what did you learn from it?
I feel like Coach Tanner said, I just came out, instead of letting the game come to me, I was trying to do too much at the wrong times. But like you said, we had a couple of guys to step up. You know, if I can't, like I said, I'm always a guy who's trying to do what's best for my team. So if that calls for me being on the bench cheering for my teammates, then that's what it is. But I mean, most importantly, I just had to bounce back from that game. I know I can't always go out and have the best game of my life, but I can always cheer my teammates on. So that's what I try to do that night.
Monty, Josh is closing in on 1,000 points for his career. Just as a teammate, kind of what does that milestone mean, and is it, how impressive is it what he's been able to do over the course of his Tennessee career?
Well, I think it definitely shows that Josh Richardson is a talented player, as we all know. And I mean, I'm very happy for him. I mean, as soon as he get the points in the game, I'm pretty sure the whole team is probably going to be cheering for him. I mean, I'm very happy for him. I think he deserves it.
Could you talk a little bit about how you're not known as a three-point shooter, but Coach Tindall set up 2 3-point shots for you. Just talk about a coach having that kind of confidence in you.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's a very big part of, you know, being a basketball player. You know, you can't always be your own motivator. You know, sometimes it calls for your coach or maybe your teammate showing that they got some type of confidence in you. You know, just always trying to go out and play outside the box. I mean, no, I haven't made a lot of three-point shots this year, but if my teammates got the confidence in me and so has my coaches, then I can feel like I can go out and knock the shot down.
Do you think you're a lot better three-point shooter than what you've shown in games so far?
Yeah, most certainly. I feel like, you know, I've never really been the type of guy who got most of my points around the basket, especially, I mean, you can't compare high school to college, but, I mean, I used to shoot threes in high school as well. So, I mean, it just starts with me, you know, standing in the gym, working on my game, making sure that I can have a consistent shot. And I think once I get that down pat, I can show a better indication of my stats.
Armani, why do you think you had so much success on offensive rebounding?
I think it's just a mentality, just going out and trying to do whatever I can to do to help my team win. You know, I might be undersized, but I feel like when I'm on the court, I don't want to let anybody else go harder than me. So having that mentality, I just always try to go out and compete. I mean, I think it's very powerful to have a guy like Martin Luther King. You know, he led by a great example. I mean, he accomplished some great things in his life. So, I mean, I think it's very powerful for us to be able to celebrate Martin Luther King Day.
Thank you.